tonight, a tragic news story about a growing problem in schools across America, bullying, and how the classroom taunts can have deadly consequences. This is a picture of Carl Joseph Walker Hoover. Now, you may remember last week we told you his story. The sixth grader's parents say he was picked on at his Massachusetts school by students who called him gay, said he was feminine. Carl later hanged himself. He was just 11 years old. His mom had to cut him down with a pair of scissors with a knife, cutting the extension cord that he used to hang himself right outside his bedroom. Tonight, a family in Georgia is experiencing similar heartache involving their 11-year-old son, who was also bullied. His mom believes that school officials failed to protect him. David Mattingly reports.
Take a look at this picture of a smiling, seemingly happy young boy and know that everything it implies about him was wrong.
He was acting strange. He didn't want to eat. You know, until the last day I saw him alive, he didn't want to go to school.
11-year-old Jaheim Herrera moved with his family from his native U.S. Virgin Islands and started at this elementary school outside Atlanta in August. He got good grades, liked to draw, and was excited about making new friends. But that's not what happened.
He was a nice little boy. He loved to dance. He loved to have fun. He loved to make friends. And all he made, they were enemies.
Friends and family say bullies at school targeted Jaheim because he was from somewhere else and spoke with an accent. They called him names and once attacked him in the restroom. One childish slur in particular affected him deeply.
What words seemed to hurt him the most?
Gay. He used to always tell me, "Mom, they keep telling me this gay word, this gay, gay, gay." I'm tired of hearing them telling me the same thing over and over.
His mother says the taunting became so bad, the unthinkable happened. Jaheim came home from school one afternoon and went up to his room. She found him hanging by a belt in his closet.
His death is not in vain, Lord.
Jaheim's suicide comes less than a month after another 11-year-old killed himself in Massachusetts after relentless bullying. Experts say everyone should be alarmed.
I think that it really is a wake-up call to everyone, to all concerned adults, to really treat bullying as a serious public health issue that it is.
Jaheim's mom says she complained multiple times to school officials, but the bullying never stopped. Other parents tell CNN they complained about bullying as well. After Jaheim's death, the school board expressed condolences, saying the school staff works diligently to provide a safe and nurturing environment for all students. Allegations of such severe bullying surprised experts who are familiar with the school system. Its anti-bullying program was considered exemplary. There are special activities designed to raise awareness. There are specially trained staff in every school. And students are even expected to sign anti-bullying pledges. But none of this was of any help to Jaheim. And in spite of recent strides made in awareness nationally, studies show that 65% of teens are being bullied each year, and most believe adults can't help them.
They reach out to adults. They don't think the adults are doing enough.
They may or may not reach out to adults, but they feel like not enough's being done.
His mother believes Jaheim gave up because all their complaints failed to protect him. She has taken her other children out of school and plans to return to St. Croix, where she says they were always safe from bullying. David Mattingly, CNN, Atlanta.
It's unbelievable. Two young boys, two tragic outcomes. So the question is, do schools understand the problem? Do parents? Joining us now is Barbara Coloroso, a parenting expert and author of The Bully, The Bullied, and The Bystander. You know, Barbara, if a kid nowadays in school if a slur is used against him based on his race, the bully will get in trouble. But if it's based on perception of sexual orientation or something else, people look the other way, it seems.
Well, first of all, my heart goes out to those two families of Carl and Jaheim's. I mean, I'm a mom and a teacher, and we've said no to racial bullying. The majority of bullying that goes on is sexual in nature, and we have got to get a handle on that. Every child needs to be able to walk into a classroom and know they're safe, that they can be treated with dignity and regard. I don't tell kids you have to like that kid in your classroom, but you must honor their humanity. And sexual bullying is on the rise. It's getting more vicious. And we have to, as parents and educators, deal with it for the seriousness that it is.
So what do you do? 39 states have anti-bullying laws. Schools around the country have zero tolerance policies in place. I mean, this school where Jaheen went, you know, people signed pledges that they wouldn't bully. It didn't seem to work.
No. What we have to do, first of all, is define bullying for what it really is. It's not normal, natural, or necessary. It's not about a fight. It's not about anger. It's about contempt for another human being. And believe me, Anderson, when I have contempt for you, I can do anything to you and not feel any shame or compassion. So when those kids called this little boy all these names, they got pleasure from that. And then after the fact, they say, oh, I'm sorry I teased you. No, you taunted him, and sorry's too late. We have to define it for what it really is, a conscious attempt to harm somebody and get pleasure from their pain. And when a child reports it to us, zero tolerance is zero thinking.
So
we have to say to that kid, I'm going to keep you safe. And what do you need from me right now as an adult in this building to be safe? And what am I going to do with the child who targeted you? And what am I going to do, not just with these two characters, there's three characters in this tragedy, the bystanders who went along with the bullying, who laughed, turned a blind eye, or were afraid to step in. They're all party to this. And what do we do with them? And how can we get a school, not to say I won't bully, but be that kid to stand up and speak out and say, stop that, that's mean. Leave him alone. He's not a bad kid.
Your son was being bullied. I guess that's how you sort of first came to this. Both these parents went to the schools of Jaheen and Carl, went to the schools, reported the problem. Again, I mean, specifically, what should a parent do?
Well, I made mistakes. Our son was targeted kindergarten through fourth grade. I handled it poorly. The school handled it worse. So I've learned from that. And one of the things you don't do is minimize, rationalize, or explain it away. You say to that targeted kid, I hear you. I'm here for you. I believe you. You're not in this alone. As a parent and an educator, I have to say that. But then when you go to the school, don't just complain. You say, this is what has been done to my child. This is the impact it's had on my child's life. And I need to know from you, one, how you're going to keep him safe or her safe, because girls get targeted relentlessly as well. And what are you going to do to follow the policies that are in place in this school already to make this targeted kid safe and hold the bully accountable? Not just suspension, not, oh, slap his hand and say, don't do that anymore, or we don't do that anymore. But he has to go through a process called restorative justice, restitution, resolution, and reconciliation. He's got to fix what he did, and not an I'm sorry.
This is the second 11-year-old boy that we have reported on in the last 2 weeks who has hung himself based on bullying. And I pray to God we do not have to do this story again, but we want to continue to follow on the subject because this is something happening across the country. I don't think a lot of people pay enough attention to. Barbara Carlarosa, the book is The Bully, The Bullied, and The Bystander. We'll have you on again. We appreciate it.
Thank you, Anderson. It's important that you bring it up all the time.
No doubt about it. Thanks, Barbara.